Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. In this video, we are going to discuss on 3.7.2, the effects of intermolecular forces and molecular shapes on physical properties of molecular compounds. So, the strength for London dispersion forces, the first factor is molar mass. So, London dispersion forces, it increases down the group 17 and 18 because as the number of electrons increase going down the group, number of electrons increases and molar mass increases as well. So, the stronger dispersion forces leads to the higher melting point and boiling point. So, the higher the molar mass, the higher the melting point and boiling point will be because of the stronger dispersion forces. The second factor is on the molecular shape or the surface area. So these two molecules, N-pentane and neopentane, have the same molar mass. It has the same molecular formula, C5H12, but it actually have different boiling points. Why does N-pentane has larger boiling points? This is the reason why, which is the molecular shape or the surface area. So as we can see here, there are larger surface area at which dispersion forces act, while for neopentane, the surface area is smaller. So due to smaller surface area, of course, the London dispersion forces will be weaker. So that's why the boiling point is lower as compared to the N-pentane just now. So this is the comparison of boiling points and melting points among the polar and nonpolar molecule. We have propane and acetaldehyde. So we can see clearly that acetaldehyde is a polar molecule because we have a high electronegative atom here. While for this one, we have a symmetrical shape of molecule. So it is a nonpolar molecule. Both propane and acetaldehyde have the same molar mass, okay, but the boiling points and melting points are different. So it has a similar molar mass but different polarity. So propane is nonpolar and acetaldehyde is polar. So the boiling points and melting points increases with the increasing polarity because we have discussed earlier in a nonpolar molecule, the type of intermolecular forces is only dispersion forces. But for acetaldehyde, it can have dispersion and dipole-dipole forces. Okay, so this is on the boiling points of compounds from group 14 to 17. As we can see here, as the molar mass of the compounds decreases, the boiling point also decreases. So, stannum, germanium, silicon, carbon. So, we can see here, the molar mass decreases. Molar mass of group 14 decreases. So, the boiling point decreases as well. Same goes with group 15 here. Antimony, arsenic and phosphorus. But not for nitrogen here. Okay, for group 16, beryllium, selenium, sulfur. So, the molar mass decreases, the boiling point decreases as well. As for this one, iodine, bromine and chlorine, it decreases as well, but not for fluorine, oxygen and nitrogen. Okay. So, H2O, HF and ammonia, it has higher boiling points due to the strong attractive forces, namely the hydrogen bond. We have discussed earlier, for hydrogen bond, it occur in molecule that contain oxygen, fluorine and nitrogen. Okay, so group 14 here, it shows gradual increase from methane to tin due to the increase of London dispersion forces as the molar mass of the molecules increases. As for solubility, polar compounds can dissolve in polar solvents. So the concept is like dissolve light. Example, we have ethanol. Ethanol is a polar molecule, so it dissolves in water, which is also a polar molecule. And nonpolar compounds, it dissolves in nonpolar solvents. As example, hexane in tetrachloromethane. So both are nonpolar, so it will be mixed well, or what we call as miscible. Miscibility or solubility is the ability to mix without separating into two phases. And what happened is actually opposite partial charges on molecules will attract to one another. So that's why it will be soluble. Okay. So please try to answer the checkpoints and discuss with your lecturers. Thank you.